increases exponentially. The public searches for the sleight of hand. Rewind. Let us see again where the traffic stop becomes murder. 4. The autopsy answers. Homicide. The public asks, what is the dead black body's criminal history? The public adds qualifiers, adjusts the narrative, reduces the dead black body's worth, are confident in its threat. Here is the slight. 5. Applause. The public examines black resilience and is dissatisfied. If you watch enough footage, you grow comfortable with a narrative. The black body will die. You begin to see it coming certain as morning. You become footage critic and note where zoom and panning would be helpful to the story. You ask the screen why the black body doesn't get up. These deaths are viewed repeatedly. You still question, was it murder? The footage confuses the law with the soldier in active combat or the hitman. The officer confuses his role. You watch again. All shots are loud. Who else heard? You think of God in the seconds before the black body falls, forward or backward. You sit in a moment of atheism. You ask the screen, where is the black body's God, as if it is missing. God is there, demanding that the black body get up. Like you, it is disappointed that the black body, too, is human. And the last one. The public, the officer, the president, apologizes. Where will you find the forgiveness? Between the syllables of the blackest names. In the good crack of a wishbone. Beneath unornamented evenings when mothers are alone with their thoughts and their gods. Among the worshipers in the promise of divine victory. Within the aura of his image, in the flesh of black backs, on the summer pavement, tart with old blood, in the damp park soil, behind the knees as one crawls towards safety or collapses in death. That is